So, much has been said about the events occurring on Saturday, the 13th of April. You have to remember that Iran waited some two weeks before they responded to Israel's violation of international law, act of aggression, war crime, bombing of the Iranian consulate in Damascus, Syria. They bowed their time. They said they would respond adequately. And even up to 72 hours prior to responding, they forewarned the United States as to what and where they will hit. And they ensured that casualties will not be had. They launched the first wave of drones. Some $68 million worth of drones. And gave a flight path of, let's say, 5 hours from the time of being launched to actually reaching Israel. The drones soared over certain territories, namely over Iraqi territory, Syrian territory, and more pertinently, Jordanian territory. The drones did what they were supposed to do. They overwhelmed the Israeli defense system, otherwise known as the Iron Dome, which, although noted for its effectiveness, is, to use an American slang term, hella expensive. And I say American slang term because America, as we know, bankrolls the satanic death cult of a state, Zionist, fanatically run Israeli government to the tune of billions. Every drone that passed through and activated the Iron Dome defense system and in turn caused Israel to use the Iron Dome was paid for by the American tax dollar. With that, Iran knew not only would they bleed the American tax dollar and Israel financially, they also would overwhelm the Iron Dome system to the point where missiles and rockets, which heretofore shot down the drones, slow moving drones, deliberately so, would be wasted. And at the same time as well, the ones which didn't hit will have to, because gravity is a real thing, crash back down to Earth with a thud. Much of the lightning and the crashes and bangs and wallops that you saw, that we see on TV, that we saw last night, were actually Israeli Iron Dome missiles coming back down to Earth because they were overwhelmed in the process of trying to shoot down the drones. But they, to use a George Bush maxim, misunderestimated the Iranians. The Iranians are very, very intelligent people. The big enchilada was the ballistic missiles, of which Iran fired eight ballistic missiles into Israel, specifically to destroy the runway, the airbase, in which the F-35s that were used to launch the fighter jets that destroyed the consulate in Damascus, Syria, that was destroyed by eight pinpoint precise unstoppable ballistic missiles which hit the target. So that was the real success on the Iranian part of last night. That was the real success. And it's something which, amidst all the hullabaloo, the Western media are not telling you about. Bernice France. The world waits with bated breath to see what Israel's response will be. The cabinet of Netanyahu have already voted to respond within the next 24 to 48 hours. Netanyahu obviously will feel he has no choice but to respond. The problem is a response risks a greater conflagration of the conflict, and the United States are not so keen doing that. We shall see. Hold on to your children.